Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 1.12 that is taken from chapter number 1, Stress, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is the control arm is subjected to the loading shown in figure 1-25A, determined to the nearest 1 over 4 inch, the required diameter of steel pins at A and C, if allowable shearing stress for the steel is 8 KSI. So you can see this is the control arm, clear, and where is the loading at this point is 5 kips, and at this point there is 3 kips load. And this is pin support at point C. The top view of this is given over here. While this rod is connected with this arm through this pin A, and its side view is given over here. And from this side view, it is shown that this bolt or this pin is only single shear, because it will shear at this point. And at point C, the top view shows that this is the pin, so it will have double shear, and the mention is, they have mentioned over here. So you have to determine the diameter of steel pins at A and C to the nearest 1 over 4 inch. So let's start with the solution. So what we will need? We will need the force acting on this pin and as well as at this pin. Clear? This force is required. So what we will do is that if you take the free body diagram of this arm, which I have shown over here, so you can see that due to this load and this load, this arm will go toward this side. So this member FB applied force on this arm in this direction, and this will be FAB, and similarly the pin will exert a vertical force CY as well as a horizontal force CX. So I will draw it over here. So this will be force FAB, and these are CX and CY, which I have already drawn. So we will find this FAB force, we will find this FAB force, this CX force, and this CY force by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moment about point C is equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about this point C, this force is and this force are not producing movement because they are passing through it. So first movement that is produced by this force FAB, and this FAB into perpendicular distance is 8, and this is producing counterclockwise movement, so it will be positive. So I can write FAB multiply by 8. Now the second force which is producing movement about this point C is 3 kips load, and perpendicular distance is 3, and it is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So I can write minus 3 multiply by 3. Now you can see this 5 kips load will have two component force if we resolve it into rectangular component. So one component will be this one, and another component will be this one. Let this is theta, so this component will be FB, this component will be 5 vertical components. For example, this I can say vertical component. So if you take cos of theta, so cos of theta will be equal to, you can see the triangle and their side ratios are shown, so cos of theta will be equal to 3/5, and sine of theta will be equal to 4/5. So this component will be equal to, this will be equal to F cos of theta, clear? Because you can see if you take cos theta, so cos theta will be equal to this divided by this. So this component will be equal to 5 into cos of theta. So I can write that, and this component is with perpendicular distance 5 is also producing clockwise distance, so it will be negative. So I can write it minus 5 times cos of theta. So cos of theta is 3/5. This will be the force, and perpendicular distance is 5. Their sum must be equal to 0. So when you solve this, you will get this FAB, and FAB comes out to be 3 kips load. Clear? Let me write this component, horizontal component will be 5 sine of theta, which will be equal to 4/5. Clear? Okay. Now we will find the CX and CY by using another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along X direction must be equal to 0. and force toward right is taken as positive. So you can see FAB and CX are acting in opposite direction. So they both will be negative. So I can write minus FAB minus CX plus this component, which is in positive direction, plus 5 multiplied by 4 divided by 5 is equal to 0. So when you solve this and plug the value of FAB, so minus 3 minus CX plus 4 is equal to 0. So from here you will get CX will be equal to 1 kip. Okay, now we'll find the CY by using another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0 and upward force is taken as positive. So you can see one force CX is upward, this is downward, and this is also downward. So their sum must be equal to 0. So CY minus 3 kips minus this 5 multiplied by 3 over 5 will be equal to 0. So when you solve this, you will get CY will be equal to 6 kips load. Now we have all these forces. So you can see CX and CY is this one. So their sum or resultant force will be in this direction. So it means that this pin is exerting a vertical load in this direction on this arm, clear? As a result of Newton's third law, this arm will exert equal and opposite force on pin in this direction. So what if I draw the pin, and let me draw it. If I draw a pin like this, so the vertical force on this pin will be C, and we will find this C by using Pythagoras theorem, which is equal to CX square plus CY square, because they are rectangular component. So just plug in the value 1 square plus 6 square under the root. So from here you will get C will be equal to, C force will be equal to 6.083 kips. Let this force I call C as equal to FC force on point C. So I can write it, it is FC, and that is 6.083 kips. Since we are told that this is double shear, so it means in order to balance it, the shear will be on these faces. Clear? So let this is V. So we'll find this V for pin C. So again, you can see that this C is equal to 2V, and from here this V is equal to C divided by 2. And when you calculate it, 6.083 divided by 2 will give you the shear force. Okay, and this shear force comes out to be 3.041 kip. Okay, now this pin is single shear, because it is given that this is single shear. So what we will do is that again I will write for pin A, we will find the diameter of pin A. So I will write that the pin, this pin is subjected to single shear. So as we know that allowable shearing stress is equal to shear force divided by shearing area. So from here we will get this area will be equal to shear force divided by allowable stress. Now for this pin, the stress act or the force acting on it will be equal to FAB, clear? And this FAB will produce shear here V. So V is equal to FAB, and this FAB is 3 kips because this is single shear. So just plug in the value 3 kips. So 3 kips divided by allowable shearing stress is given as how much? This is 8 KSI, so it means that 8 kip per square inch. Clear? And we know that this area is equal to area of pin is equal to pi by 4 d a square. Diameter of pin A is equal to 3 divided by A. So when you solve this, you will get diameter of pin A is equal to how much? 0.691 inch. And you can see that we have been asked to determine this diameter to nearest 1 over 4. So 1 over 4 is 0.25. 1 over 2 over 4 is again 0.5. So it is greater than 0.5. So we will select diameter of A is equal to 3 by 4 inch. 3 by 4 is 0.75. So this value is less than 0.75. But we will choose this in order to that this pin will remain safe. Now what we will do is that we will move for pin C. So the pin C is subjected to double shear because it is given in the question. I will show you here double shear, clear? So it will shear over at this point and in this point, and we have found out the shear force for pin C is this one. So we will use again the same formula, this one. So area is equal to shear force divided by allowable shearing stress. Shear force is 3.041 kips divided by allowable shearing stress is 8 kips per square inch, and diameter of pin C is pi by 4 dc power 2 is equal to 3.041 divided by 8. So when you solve this, dc square is equal to 3.041 multiplied by 4 divided by 8, and you when you calculate it and take the square root, so you will get this DC will be equal to 0.696. And again, this 0.696 is approximately equal to in nearest to 1 over 4 inch, it is equal to 3 by 4 inch. So again, you have to use both the pin having diameter 3 by 4 inch, which is the answer of our this question. And that was all about this example 1.12. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.